Esperanto is an international language that developed on the basis of a project launched by a young man in Poland in 1887, and it has spread all over the world. There are today people who speak it in more than 120 countries. Mass media, politicians, most linguists, and the man in the street ignore it completely. But it lives and is in daily use in a segment of the world population. As a former UN translator, I can testify that Esperanto is an excellent language for translation. It's more precise than English, and thus better suited to legal and scientific texts. It lends itself very well to humor and to poetry, and is particularly good for expressing feelings and emotions, since the forms that come up spontaneously have never to be inhibited by exceptions, complicated grammar, or the lack of a consistent system of derivation. In Esperanto, if you know how to say moon, you don't have to learn luna. You form it yourself. Luno, luna. Just as city, urban, urbo, urba. Year, annual, jaro, jara. This possibility of freely combining invariable elements, a feature that Esperanto shares with Chinese, gives you a rich and expressive vocabulary without imposing too much work to memory. I've attended hundreds of international meetings held in English, hundreds with simultaneous interpretation, and hundreds in Esperanto. The only really lively ones, the ones with equal participation of all, the ones in which people can really be spontaneous and at ease, are the Esperanto ones. The language is so structured that the form that comes to mind is the right form. 6 months of Esperanto brings you to a communication level that you haven't yet reached after 6 years in another language, including English. Esperanto is really cost-effective, especially if in cost you include time and effort. I've spoken Esperanto with local residents in more than 50 countries, from Japan to Brazil or the Netherlands to Uzbekistan, and I've always found it extremely pleasant. In Esperanto, you can be yourself. In English, non-natives have to try and imitate a foreign model, knowing that they'll never succeed perfectly. The miracle of Esperanto is that you can keep your accent and your way of forming your sentences, and yet everybody understands everybody, and no one ever feels inferior, ridiculous, or simply foreign. For instance, to express the idea, I've learned it really quickly, people will say, according to their origin, Mi lernis gin vere rapide. Vere rapide, mi lernis gin. Mi gin lernis vere rapide. Or, gin vere rapide, mi lernis. And 1 century of use has proven that these differences do not impair perfect mutual understanding. Since 1985, there hasn't been a single day without Esperanto being used for an international convention, conference, or other encounter somewhere in the world. It is widely used on the net, and there is an Esperanto version of Google and one of Wikipedia. A political will to promote it would cure humankind of the aphasia from which most of us suffer when we have to interact with foreigners. A coordinated action by governments to organize its teaching in all schools of the world, and a recommendation to adults to devote to it 10 minutes a day for 3 months. 10 minutes, that's less than what you need to do a crossword puzzle or a Sudoku, would start a snowball process which after a while would completely change the language panorama of our planet. Everybody would retain their mother tongues, but have at their disposal a practical means of communicating with people from any country. There would be more fairness for all people, better mutual understanding in all fields, and a much better use of taxpayers' money. Economist François Grin has calculated that if Europe adopted Esperanto, this would mean a saving of 25 billion euros per year. That is an annual saving of 35 billion US dollars. Aren't all these facts worth being seriously considered and acted upon?